The overall level of completion is currently at 76% as work on the new passenger terminal is yet to commence. The China Communications Construction Company has blamed delays in execution of the contract to COVID-19 and delayed payments by the government of Uganda, which frustrated the smooth running of the project.
First, it's about the COVID. Because of lockdown, because of the sort of materials of all over the world. This is the first reason. And secondly, it's about the delay payment of the employee. You know, when they did the repairs, we don't have the money to buy the materials to pay our supplier. So that is the reason that makes the project delay.
The cargo center works have been fully completed and handed over to the client. It is estimated that cargo transport through Entebbe Airport will grow at a rate of 6.5% per year and continue to do so for the next 17 years with the new facility in place.
In this new cargo building, we have cargo handling equipment that is able to carry cargo off of a truck and then deliver it into these beds, roller beds. That is new equipment that you have not seen around. If you look at other equipment, like for instance in the wet areas, we have modern fittings that we have installed, modern toilets and modern faucets that we have installed. We have also installed new pressure pumping systems to ensure that we have standard water pressures.
Also completed are the new cargo center's aircraft parking apron, the cargo center's landslide and airside access roads. Most of the completed works, such as runways, taxiways and parking aprons, are already operational.
For this cargo, it's about 10,000 square meter, and this cargo can handle around 10,000 tons cargoes per year. Yeah.
The cost
for this cargo? Let me ask my colleague.
While addressing journalists today, Mr. Lee Kin Poo explained queries of the Parliamentary Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises over controversial variation of the contract, which cost the government of Uganda an extra $3.4 million. Uganda acquired a concessional loan from Exim Bank to the tune of $200 million to expand, upgrade and modernize Entebbe International Airport. Meanwhile, Parliament considered and passed the Markets Bill 2021 yesterday to repeal the Markets Act Cap 94 of 1942. The bill seeks to provide a comprehensive legal framework to strengthen the regulation, management and administration of markets. The Markets Bill 2021 is a private member's bill moved by Honorable Margaret Rwabashaija, the Workers' MP. The bill provides for registration of all vendors in public markets and regulates election of the market management committees for vendors.
It was formulated in 1942, long before we had this policy of decentralization. The market was, the law was not allowing private markets. Now we have private markets. The law was not conceptualizing that we have a KCCA, which has its own markets. You are talking of Minister of Local Government in charge of everything. But now we have the Minister of Kampala under taking charge of the markets in KCCA. So me, I'm happy with Honorable Wabushija. We supported her. It's a private member's bill. I know what a private member's bill is. Very difficult. So I congratulate her and I congratulate Parliament. But this is going to help us to streamline the affairs of markets, relations between the vendors and their committees, relationship between the vendors and the local authorities, management of the private markets by local authorities. It's all about improving the regulatory framework, and that's what we've done.
Any plans for the
The bill has provided for private ownership of markets but outlawed multiple ownership of stalls in the private markets, meaning one vendor, one stall. Councillors and civil servants have been prohibited from owning stalls in public markets to cure the element of conflict of interest from public servants, which has been escalating wrangles in public markets.
You can be a vendor in your market. You can go and start a market. You can go and work in a private market. But we are talking of a public market, a market which is owned by the local authority, where you, the councillor, you are actually the governor there. It would be a conflict of interest. that you are the secretary for finance, you need revenue from the market, but you are also the vendor in that particular market. How will you manage this one? We've seen also the examples we've had in some of the markets, and I've given Parliament the example of Mbali. The minute we put our foot down in the guidelines, we say no, you are a technical officer, a civil servant, you are a councillor, except the councillor who was a vendor before he became a councillor, she became a councillor. You stay because you are the monitor, you are the overseer.
The markets bill has placed hefty penalties on perpetrators of vandalism in public markets with a fine of 2 million shillings or a jail term of 2 years. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.